Hello everyone, this is Ashish Jain. This is another video on payment and declaration of dividend. In this video, we will talk about the dividend declaration that we have already discussed in the last video. That is, what are the options available for the company to make payment to shareholders. Now, today we are discussing about the if the company are going to declare dividend out of accumulated profit, then the company need to comply with rule number 3. Okay, so first point is, in case of inadequacy or absence of profit, how will company declare dividend out of accumulated profit? In this case, dividend declared out of profits earned in previous year and transfer to resources to reserve, such declaration should be according to rule number 3. That means, if the company having not a sufficient amount of profit in the current year, then they will declare out of the previous year, then they will transfer such amount to reserve. But these transfer from profit to reserve, that should be as per rule number 3. Okay, now there are some exemptions. These exemptions are only given to government companies. That means this rule is not applicable to government company. Actually, the thing is, as per the stated language in the law, there is no clarity whether this exemption is related not to declare dividend or not to follow rule number 3. So there is no clarity. So for the exemption point of view, I always suggest to all students that as per ICAI rules, they have suggested to write that this exemption is not related to the declaration dividend. That means, for the government company, if the government company do not have sufficient amount of profit, then they will not declare dividend. Okay. Now, next point is, dividend shall be declared and paid only out of free reserves. What are free reserves? These are basically called distributable reserve. That means, those reserves which are freely, or you can say fully distributable. Okay, like basically the company have two kinds of reserve. Like some of the reserves are basically created for the specific purpose, such as amalgamation, reversion. They are basically created for the specific purpose, and some of are basically fully free. That means they can be utilized for any purpose. Okay, so here it means dividend shall be declared and paid only out of free reserves. Okay, now let's talk briefly about what is actually rule number 3. Rule number 3 means all these four conditions need to be fulfilled to comply with rule number 3. First point is, rate of dividend should not be less than the average. The rate of dividend should be less than the average of immediately 3 preceding previous year, as we have already briefly discussed in the last video. Okay, first and second point is, total amount drawn from such reserve should be less than or equal to 10% of paid up share capital and free reserves. That means, whatever amount they are drawing from reserve, that should be 10% of profit sharing capital plus free reserves. Okay, then amount so drawn should be first utilized to set off losses incurred in previous year in which dividend is declared. Obviously, that means if company have already lost in the last 5 years, and if company made a huge amount of profit in this year, so company first utilize the current year profit to set off all the previous year losses first. Then they may draw such amount of reserve to declare dividend. Now, balance of reserve after withdrawal should not be less than 15% of paid up share capital. That means the company need to make a balance or maintain a balance in the profit sharing capital, that is more than or equal to 15% of profit sharing capital after withdrawing such amount of declaration. Okay, now let's talk about this point. First point, this point basically saying that the company that the rate of dividend should be less than the average of immediately preceding year. Now 4.11, if no dividend declared in the 3 preceding year, then this rule number 3 is not applicable. Not applicable. I said this rule number 3 fulfill only when all these conditions are fulfilled, but this first point is not fulfilling. Why? Because company didn't declare any dividend in the last 3 preceding years. Okay, but if the company declared only declared in 2 preceding years, then the average will be taken of 3 years. That means we will divide by 3. So this rule is not applicable only when the company didn't declare any dividend in the last 3 preceding year. Okay, so this is the all about rule number 3. The next we will do in the next videos. Thank you.